It's 2012. A guy walks into a Target in Minneapolis, pissed off, fuming that the store sent his teenage daughter coupons for things like cribs and baby clothes, almost going so far as to say that they're encouraging her to get pregnant. Now, a couple days later, he calls Target back up, only this time to apologize. It turns out that his daughter actually was pregnant. She just didn't know it yet. Target was analyzing customers' buying habits and looking for patterns. For example, lots of people bought lotion, but women with a baby registry were buying unscented lotion a lot more. Add up all those buying habits, and you can predict what someone will buy next, what they'll do next. This story freaked out a lot of people back in 2012, and over the course of the next 10 years, artificial intelligence, machine learning, and algorithms have only gotten more efficient at what they do, knowing you. Every time you browse a website or go shopping, you share a little bit about yourself. Bits of data that algorithms can calculate to predict what you'll want to buy next, when you'll be pregnant, when you'll quit your job, or even when you'll die. Targeted ads are one thing, but is it possible to predict your future with a machine or a software? And if it is, what does that mean about free will? Today, data is more valuable than oil because of the knowledge that companies can extract from that information. And knowledge is power, especially when you're trying to sell something to someone. Companies are spending billions of dollars to know more about you than you know about yourself. But humans trying to predict the future isn't anything new. From ancient Mayans predicting the end of the world to the Oracle of Delphi dishing out prophecies brought on by inhaling hallucinogenic gases, humans have been trying to figure out what happens before it happens for a very long time. Remember this formula you learned about in high school? The Pythagorean theorem, named after the Greek philosopher Pythagoras. This guy had some very interesting ideas about the world. He believed that everything in the universe had a number associated to it, and the cult-like group that he led spent years analyzing the numbers of things in the world they did know about to calculate the things they didn't. It sounds like magic, but believe it or not, this is still being used today in a multi-billion dollar industry. Sports. Baseball was the first sport to use this magic to its advantage, but some used it more than others. While most teams only used analytics during player transactions, the Houston Astros brought the numbers game onto the field, and it won them their first World Series in 2017. The Chicago Blackhawks hadn't won a Stanley Cup in nearly 50 years. In 2009, they hired an outside company to come in and break down and analyze their player data. They went on to win 3 cups in 6 seasons. That doesn't happen. And big wins aren't just happening in sports. A team of scientists at MIT have even created an artificial intelligence that will, with enough data, be able to predict breast cancer much earlier than we can today. But there's a dark side to all this that makes a lot of people very uncomfortable. Because if an artificial intelligence can predict everything that you're gonna do before you do it, that has some pretty massive implications. Imagine you're applying for a job and an algorithm looks at your CV, where you live, and a bunch of other data points. Finally, it decides there's a 75% chance that you're probably gonna quit within a year. So the company hires someone with a lower quit score. People are still having a hard time deciding if humans do or don't have free will, the ability to make your own decisions. And if a program can sum you up in a matter of seconds and predict the next 10 moves that you're gonna make before you do, does it even matter? Machine learning isn't a perfect science, but it might soon be used that way. So what can you do about it? Well, other than convincing the people in charge of this stuff that they can't just reduce you to a bunch of information on a page, you essentially need to know yourself better than these algorithms to outsmart the algorithm. Get to know yourself, the way you think, and how you make the decisions you make. A lot of us are on autopilot for most of our day-to-day. Finding out why you do what you do is the first step to understanding how your machine works, how you work. And from there, it's about understanding that the machine is only guessing what you do next based on what you've done in the past. But, of course, you have the option to do something you would never have done before. While the machines might know you now, it's up to you to decide where you go next. And the most important thing you can do, above all else, hit that subscribe button so you never miss another episode of Technality.